am considering the PRP or the Vampire Facelift. Any suggestions? I have had many Fraxel laser treatments with great results, but I'm thinking this is the next step. How much more results can I expect from the 10 Fraxel treatments chemical peels?
Thank you for your question. In the question you submitted with the single photo, you're asking how much more benefit can you receive compared to the procedures that you've had with a certain number, approximately 10 or 11 or so Fraxel treatments, and you're considering PRP or the Vampire Facelift. So what I think is important is for you to understand what the definitions of these procedures are and what the expected outcomes are, and let's see if this merges well or blends well with what your intention is. I'm a cosmetic oculofacial plastic surgeon. I specialize in facial rejuvenation, and I've been using platelet-rich plasma as well as performing the Vampire Facelift for several years. And I can understand why there's some confusion and the terms being used interchangeably. So let's start with just definitions. What is platelet-rich plasma? Platelet-rich plasma is derived from your own blood, and it's based on a simple principle of concentrating the platelets and the growth factors, the key elements of wound healing that are in your blood that are typically necessary for when you have a simple cut. And what's fascinating about PRP is the applications that preceded the use of platelet-rich plasma in our field, in the cosmetic field. Platelet-rich plasma was first mentioned in the medical literature in terms of its use in oral surgery. Dentists or oral surgeons or implant specialists were using it to help improve blood supply in bone so that when they were placing the titanium implants into the bone to hold a dental implant, it would hold and heal better. It was also embraced in orthopedics for joint healing. It was also embraced in wound healing technology. So in the aesthetic field, what we are using platelet-rich plasma for is to improve skin quality, to stimulate skin qualities, to enhance skin quality through the stimulation of collagen formation and blood supply. A very common report we get from patients, and we do a lot of platelet-rich plasma treatments in our practice, is that their skin has this wonderful glow. And it's a great distinction that platelet-rich plasma is able to accomplish compared to fillers. Now, where does it sit in terms of the devices such as Fraxel or other ablative laser technology? Well, I explain it in my practice in this way. There is a certain amount of skin quality enhancement that is possible with laser treatments. This includes various versions of erbium lasers such as Fraxel, CO2 lasers such as the fractional CO2 laser. What is the basic principle is ablation or removal, and that can be accomplished with not just a laser but with a dermabrasion or a chemical peel, will stimulate the skin to create collagen. That collagen results in a smoothening of the skin or improvement in the appearance of fine lines and wrinkles. Then there's the thermal aspect, which is not created with chemical peeling, that has a unique advantage in that it causes some contraction of the dermis and tightening of the skin. It also stimulates a certain amount of collagen. So what I try to explain is that while we can do a lot with lasers from the outside, platelet-rich plasma is doing a lot for the skin from the inside. It stimulates the fatty cell layer under the skin. It stimulates, again, collagen production, And we have been using it successfully for treatment of acne scars, for fine lines and wrinkles. And as a separate development in our practice, we use it in combination with acellular matrix for hair loss. And it's been incredibly successful, and it's really been fantastic. But it, platelet-rich plasma in that respect is more of a vehicle and a catalyst for what else we do for hair regeneration. Now, the vampire facelift is a controversial term because essentially I think it's because the name, and the name doesn't necessarily communicate exactly what it does, but I can in no way argue with the success of its name as a brand. Vampire Facelift has been so popular in terms of its name that it continues for at least for a long time to be more popular than the term Botox in terms of search. And the idea of the Vampire Facelift and the concept was developed by Dr. Charles Runnels, who I've met personally and I actually spent time with to learn what exactly his vision was in developing this very strangely named procedure. And the concept that he introduced was that hyaluronic acid filler, such as Restylane, does a very nice job of adding volume. But there is also a synergy when combining hyaluronic acid with platelet-rich plasma that can restore volume in a more effective way than hyaluronic acid alone or platelet-rich plasma alone. So a vampire facelift is actually the strategic use of one syringe, that's typically 1 milliliter, of a hyaluronic acid filler such as Restylane, Juvederm, or Bellotero, and combined with platelet-rich plasma injected strategically in various areas where there is volume loss. So for hyaluronic acid placement, it can be the lateral eyebrow, it can be the cheek area, the tear trough, the area under the corners of the mouth. Essentially, his idea is to, and why it's called a facelift, for a surgeon like myself who does a lot of facelifts, facelifting is still vertical and posterior elevation of descending soft tissue so that you lift the cheeks, define the jawline, define the neck. For Dr. Runnels, it meant volume expansion in terms of lifting the face not upward but away from the bone so that you get volume. The observation that we're all aware of is that as we get older, we lose volume, so we become more, quote, skeletonized. So the vampire facelift, in terms of your desire, has to be put into that context. If you feel you want to have this synergy and this combination, then usually there is a superior benefit in combining a filler with PRP as opposed to PRP alone. I think the reason a lot of my colleagues have a lot of disdain for this terminology is because it implies by the word facelift that there's an actual vertical lifting. A lot of our colleagues also have question about the benefit of PRP because a lot of times it is misrepresented as a substitute for fillers. Platelet-rich plasma, PRP, is not a substitute for fillers. It is something that works very well in conjunction with fillers, but it does something very unique that fillers do not do. So with that understanding, I hope that you'll be able to make this decision on whether or not to do or pursue this new regenerative concept of using platelet-rich plasma to improve the quality of skin. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck, and thank you for your question.